a guy that they think has an unbelievable upside. You look at that 186 average from a year ago, and I think we can all sit here and admit that is not the offensive production you expect from Gary Sanchez. That is not the offensive production you're going to get from Gary Sanchez next year. The pass balls, that's really what Yankees fans go crazy about, and as you sit there and watch that, it is infuriating at times, but there are some things that he does well behind the plate that you also have to recognize.
There are a lot of things with me with Gary Sanchez, and I think about health right away, right? Had that shoulder cleaned up, the left shoulder, you would expect his offensive numbers immediately to get better because he's probably going to be healthy moving forward. But again, you talk about how infuriating it is. It must be the same way for the organization. When you watch somebody that's as talented as Gary Sanchez struggle behind the plate, you get frustrated, but then they also know how good and talented he is moving forward, and everybody's like, oh, trade him for the catcher for the Marlins, Real Muto, and bring him in here. What about what Gary Sanchez goes and becomes an all-star for the next 6 or 7 years? From an organizational standpoint, they know what they have. It's their job to make him better and become that consistent all-star player year in and year out.
Yeah, I would not trade Gary Sanchez. And I do think the defensive side can get better, and I do think there are things that he does well defensively that get lost because of the pass balls. Let's face it, as a catcher, if one of the things that you have struggled with is the art of catching the ball, it's going to get a ton of attention, and it should. It's the offensive lineman who you're fine until you let up a sack, and then everybody remembers that sack. But let's not forget what Sanchez has done offensively. I mentioned these numbers the other day. 266 career games, he's hit 71 home runs. He's tied with Joe DiMaggio for the fourth best for the most home runs in the first 266 games of your career. You can't ignore that. You wait for the defense to catch up, but that offense is something you can't just gloss over and act like it doesn't exist.
And that's what